Day 505. So, day 7 of fasting, right? I get up, I set my alarm for before sunrise, and, you know, ready to wake up and go biking, and I wake up and I hear thunder. And it's raining, and it was predicted to rain through 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock. So that kind of threw my day off. I ended up going and doing my grocery shopping for the week, or for the 5 days. And then I did some stuff around the house, cooked a round of food for Zane, and then just kind of laid around the house until it was time to go biking. And because it was in the evening and I'd kind of gotten used to this, get up, go, and then relax, it was kind of difficult to get out the door. And then I had originally planned on trying to push myself to do the most that I'd ever done while fasting, which would be do the climb up to my office and then do the climb across the way, across the bridge, which normally would take me about 2 hours. So I got up, got out, and got out with about an hour and 50 minutes before sunset, and I was dragging the whole time. And, you know, it's one of those things where, you know, I'm on day 7 of fasting, and there's, when you push the first mile or two, I always expect, or at least with hiking, with biking, it's usually the first, you know, 10, 15 minutes. While fasting, I drag, and I don't want to be there, and I'm tired, and I really think it has something to do with, like, my body's ability to convert the energy, and it needs to realize, like, oh, you're active. I need to give you more energy right now, because otherwise, you're not going to make it, right? And so I, then it usually picks up. Well, ooh, a little bug. Well, this last time, that wasn't the case, right? I dragged, for the most part, all the way to the office. I basically, as I crested the hill to start the climb to the office, I was like, I've got time to do one or the other based on the time to get back. I can either go across the bridge or I can go to the office. And I was like, immediately go to the office, because that's the one that I've done the most. It's a little harder. It's more intense, right? The climb across the bridge takes longer, and it's a long, slow uphill climb. The climb into the office, it gets steep and then it gets flatter. And I, you know, got to the point where, you know, my problem was cars kept going by. So I actually did the most straight uphill climb I've done the whole time I've done that, without stopping, and without the e-bike, right? So because cars just kept coming by and I couldn't cut across. And so I kept pedaling, and somehow I made it to the top, and I felt like I wanted to throw up at the end of it. But I was like, just keep going, just keep going. And then I got up and I did the circle around, and then I stopped. And then on the way back, I just had this most defeatist kind of mentality. But I had to get home, right? And that was the method home. And it's like, you get off my bike and walk. Like, I thought about that multiple times. I can get off my bike and walk. And it's like, no, that's not acceptable. If I have to, I have to stop. And I did end up stopping on the last hill 2 times, which I didn't necessarily need. But I just did it. So either way, I got that done, and I got through it, and now I've got a hike tomorrow morning. The weather looks fine in the morning, so I'll be getting out bright and early to go do probably the longest hike that I've ever done while fasting this late in the game. I tried to do it once before, but I only ended up doing 4 miles. This time I'm going to do it the opposite direction than I normally do. And that way I really don't have a cutout. I either have to do it all or not. So we'll see how that goes tomorrow.